Make sure you can see him right from the side. So John goes down to setup position for me. All right. I might make a quick fix here. For me, where his shoulder is, we're kind of just flirting with being pretty darn close to behind the bar, which we never want. So John, I might just pick your hips up a little bit. Make sure you wiggle your toes so I can see you rooted back in the heels. I like that a little bit better. And stand. Now what I want you guys to do, we're gonna look at this in three different ways. The first place I wanna look is at the back itself. So if he goes down to setup position, keep those hips high, hips high, hips high, there you go. We should see that the back angle stays the same as the bar comes up to the knee. You're gonna pull super slow, John, and we're gonna stand. And stand. That one was actually a little bit better than we started, and here's another way we can look at this. Back down to mid-shin. Okay, I want you guys to watch the knee. You should actually see the knee slide back as he starts to stand. And stand. Good. And then lock that leg out as you stand up. So once you get past the knee, John, you're kind of keeping the knee a little bent. I want you to continue to straighten the knee once you're past it. Down to mid-shin. Did you guys see the knee move as he started to pull? That's a good sign. Now, a third thing we can look at is this bar path should be nice and straight or slightly back. I shouldn't see it bow around the knee. You still holding? Good job. Ready. Nice and slow and stand. Straighten the knee, straighten the knee, straighten the knee. There we go. I like that nice straight leg. How do you do on bar path? Pretty good. So three different ways to look at that. One, we can analyze that back angle. Hips and shoulders can rise at the same rate. Two, we can watch the knee, and there is a too much, right? If you catch your athlete and they push the knee back, the legs are straight and they're bent over, that's too much leg drive. That's that stiff leg deadlift that we don't want. The knee should just move back slightly in order to get out of the way. Now, another thing that can make this easier for you guys to dial in on and see it, if I'm warming an athlete up or we're just teaching this movement, I can do what I did to the whole group and just take him from shin to knee. Having to look at less real estate makes that a little bit easier. So one last time, go down to mid-shin, and then you're gonna pause right when you get to the kneecap. And the kneecap. Good, and back down mid-shin. I wanna see the hips come up a little bit more when I say up to the knee. Up to the knee, that was better, down to mid-shin. Again, push the knees back a little bit more, up to the knee. Better, and back down to mid-shin. Now do we see how that back angle stays the same? And then we can have him pull. Nice, John, and stand all the way up. Good job, and relax. Any questions about that?